Hi everyone, I'm Lisa Whitaker. Many of you know me as one of the missionaries from our church. Right now I'm in Krakow, Poland, as you can see. This is one of the churches behind me in the main square of Krakow. So I've been here for the last week. We've had our International Discipleship Training School Center staff come and gather together here in Krakow to worship together, pray, plan for the future, look at how we can invest in people's lives in the coming years ahead. And one of the things we did on our day off is we actually visited Oskar Schindler's factory, which many of you will know from the movie Schindler's List. And as we went through the factory, there was a very extensive explanation of what happened here prior to the war, as the war was stirring up, and how Germany came in and took over. But one of the things that really struck me was when they were talking about Oskar Schindler. He came here as a German, as a businessman, and his goal was to take advantage, really, most likely his goal was to take advantage of the businesses that was gonna be afforded to him when the Jews were taken away. And so one of the people that he ended up saving in the end wrote about Oskar Schindler and said that he came here with the idea of business, but his moral transformation happened not overnight, but day by day as he interacted with the Jews in his factory. And he saw that they were not just cheap laborers, but they were actually human beings. And it came to the point where other Jews wanted to work at Schindler's factory because he was feeding them, he was not beating them, and he was treating them much better than the other businessmen who hired Jews in the region. But what struck me was the fact that this person said his moral transformation was not immediate. It was day by day. And there was this realization that the people he was interacting with were real human beings. And as I've been thinking about that, I've been thinking of the world situation and just really praying prayers that we would have more of that take place, where people would interact with those who maybe they don't agree with or they don't understand, and their transformation would be that they would see these people as human beings. Because we all know we're made in the image of God, and every nation's Bible, every language group's Bible says you are made in the image of God, whether that's written in English or Polish or Hebrew, whatever it is, you're made in the image of God. And so let's keep that in mind as we move forward, and let's pray for a revelation within the church in America and within the church worldwide that we are all made in the image of God.